Do you know either of these two people? If so, you are in the right place. If not, well, you are welcome all the same. Welcome to Jazz Club. No, we are here today for one of the most beautiful things, a wedding between the oh-so-fabulous Robyn and Forsyth and the he-ain't-heavy-he's-my-brother, Dafydd Russell Jones. Now, as strange as it might be, we are absolutely thrilled to have you with us. And wherever you might be in the world watching this, you are part of it too. You are part of it too. Now, are you sitting comfortably? Cup of tea, glass of bubbly? Then we'll begin.
Fancy seeing you here.
Hello.
Hello, Croeso, and welcome to the hottest wedding going on in North London, no, all of London, today.
Still there?
Now, seeing as we can't all be here in person, we're going to kick things off with a selection of videos which have been sent from far and wide.
First there's going to be some of you,
and then some of Dav's,
and then it's back to you.
Something of a Dafydd sandwich, if you will. Delicious. Full of love, full of joy. Enjoy.
Can I get a witness?
Oh, hey, congratulations today, guys. Greetings from Canada. Gotta get the bird in there. Obviously I'd love to be there with you. I miss you guys. I have some words for you from James Baldwin, who says that if love will not swing wide the gates, no power will or can. So I pray and I trust that your lives together will be a testimony to the power of love. So I pray that God will bless you and keep you, and I hope to see you guys soon. So yeah, congratulations.
Hi Robyn, hi Dafydd, congratulations on your wedding. Robyn, I absolutely adore you. You're an amazing woman and you deserve all the happiness in the world. Thank you for letting me be a part of your wedding, and yeah, I just hope you both have a long and prosperous life together, and love you lots. Bye.
Hey guys, I just wanted to wish you both a big congratulations on your special day. I'm sad that I can't be there to celebrate with you both, but I'm excited to see it on the big screen. Sending my love to you both, and I can't wait till we can all celebrate properly in person in the near future.
Hello Dav and Robyn, just a quick message to say, hope you have an amazing wedding, and I wish you a lifetime of happiness. All the best, lots of love.
Hi Robyn and Dafydd.
We're sorry we can't all be there today.
We're sending you our very best wishes for your very big day.
And wish you health and happiness in your future together. Love from us all.
Hello.
Hi.
This is Kay from Nowhere Hill.
This is Julia, also from Nowhere Hill.
So we both met Robyn whilst working with her. We just wanted to take this opportunity to wish you a happy and healthy and wonderful wedding. It's a shame that we can't be with you there personally.
Have a lovely day, be happy, wish you a wonderful life ahead of you, and lots of love. And also, don't forget to make time, Robyn, in your busy schedule, to have some dates with us again.
And cigar.
Because we'll be missing you. Lots of love.
Bye.
Hi, Dafydd and Robyn, Donny here. Just wanted to wish you all the best and a massive congratulations on your big day. Hope you have an absolutely fantastic day. Really sorry that we couldn't all be there to celebrate with you, but I'm sure we're all looking forward to the time when we can all be together and celebrate. Most importantly, I want to wish you a long and happy life together, and I hope you have an amazing day today. All the best.
Good morning. Greetings from a very wet Edinburgh and best wishes.
And we hope that Saturday will be a much nicer day for you. than it is here today. We hope you have a lovely day, Dafydd and Robyn. Sorry we can't be with you, but hopefully we can have a lovely family get together in the not too distant future. Have a lovely day, have a happy day, and we hope that you have a wonderful life together. Bye.
Bye.
Hey, Robyn and Dafydd.
Congratulations.
Yeah, congrats, guys. We're so really excited for y'all. So neat. Dafydd, it was so awesome just to connect with you at Regent. Fond memories of going to random houses and trying to find a place to live together. And then...
Oh, yeah, you guys did that.
Yeah, we did that.
Yeah.
Chaos.
Didn't work out.
Yeah. So... We're always living together in spirit. But yeah, then fond memories also of us playing soccer. And then Robyn, great to connect with you over Facebook.
Really good. Really good. It was really nice to meet you, even in just a short period of time. And we'd love to obviously get to know you a little bit more. But we're really happy for you guys and happy for the new opportunities that have come up, or I guess the long-awaited opportunities that have come up for both of you with regards to jobs and whatnot. Dafydd, I have to say, whenever we played soccer together, I would always tell Danny this, that you reminded me of an elf. Because you it's a huge compliment, because you were just everywhere all the time and very light on your feet playing soccer, and it just made me laugh. So we love you guys very much, and we wanted to share a couple of quotes with you in honor and celebration of your special day. So this is a quote from Dr. Zeus, which is always a wonderful, reliable source to quote on a wedding day. He says this: "We are all a little weird, and life's a little weird. And when we find someone whose weirdness is compatible with ours, we join up with them and fall in mutual weirdness and call it love."
Mm.
That's one of my favorites.
Get to be weird.
And then together. Danny wants to share an African proverb with you.
Yeah, so this is an African proverb just for y'all, and it says this: a happy man marries the woman he loves. A happier man loves the woman he marries.
That's really good.
It is good. Like we said at the beginning, we just love y'all so much, and we are really excited for you as you enter into this chapter, in this new journey as husband and wife now, and we're praying for y'all. We're thinking of you on this day.
Wish we could be there.
Yeah, we'll tune in and watch it live online.
Looking forward to that.
Yeah, get that stream going. We just wanted to send our love and our greetings from Danny and Jenna over here in Vancouver. Much love.
Hope we can see you soon.
We'll see you guys later. Ciao.
And now for a word from our sponsor. And now for a word from our sponsor. And now for a very special word from the man of the hour. Groom. He's the groom. Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness?
Hello, croeso. Welcome to Robyn and Dafydd's wedding. You've surfed through the algorithms of time at just the right moment to capture this. I'm going to give you a little video to warm you up for the wedding, and just to welcome you. Well done for making it this far. We're going to show some more of your videos in a second to welcome everybody to the wedding and make your virtual presence felt in this wedding. We have a service sheet ready, and we've shared that. If you'd like to get that ready, the service is going to start in 30 minutes approximately, sometime in the next half an hour when the beautiful bride has arrived. Who knows when that will be, but I have every hope that she's going to be here. And yes, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about our journey of how we came together and how we've arrived at this place and time to get married to each other. So here I am standing outside of Shandy Street, which is where the interns lived. We met together on the intern program in 2019, and there's 8 interns. I lived here with 5 other interns, and Robyn lived in a different place. But we spent a lot of time here doing social events, eating together in Stepney Green in East London, and Robyn was living in De Beauvoir. But I decided to set up a book club, and I invited all the interns, I invited other friends that I had in London, and I asked people if they'd like to read Dietrich Bonhoeffer's book Life Together. So I invited everybody and told them to meet me at the Husk Cafe, which is just a little bit further down in Mile End, and we'll discuss the book together. So let's go down to Husk Cafe and see what happened next. So here was, I arrived at the Husk Cafe. Dietrich Bonhoeffer, Life Together, lots of aspirations to share the deep knowledge that I gained from this amazing book. But who was the only person who turned up? Of course, it was Robin, the only one who read the book and cared to keep me company. Otherwise, it would have been a complete flop on the book club front. But we enjoyed talking about this book, and we really engaged with each other's minds and our love for literature and for the deep knowledge of God. And we just really spent time going to the pub afterwards, talking about these things, and yeah, we really fell in love with each other's minds and brains. And we spent many nights just talking long into the night and talking about all kinds of things. And we don't agree on everything, transubstantiation being one of them, but we saw past that, and we were quickly getting more and more in love with each other and crazy about each other. And then one evening, Robin surprised me. Yes, Robin decided to take me to St. Paul's, and when we arrived here, I thought we were going to go to some sort of mass gathering, a midnight mass or something rosemary bead related activity. But we got here and she actually took me to a restaurant. At that time I thought, this must be the time where she wants to tell me that she loves me. And even if she doesn't want to tell me that she loves me, I'm going to tell her that I love her, because that was all I could think about at that time. And we sat down, we had real heart to heart, and realized we wanted to do life together, do ministry together. And so I told Robin that I loved her, and she eventually said it back, I think out of her own free will, but nonetheless she said it. And we knew from that moment onward that we wanted to make it work. And things moved quite quickly after that.
We had serious conversations with each other about marriage, and we spoke to our friends and families about this as well. And we also prayed to God, and we asked God if he would bless this union and if this was the right thing to do for us. And one morning I told Robin to meet me here at St. Monica's Church, and she came sitting in the pew, but I had other plans and I was sitting by the canal.
This is the bench where I waited for Robin, and I waited here with some flowers to surprise her. And as you can see, a really romantic spot, but it's a meaningful one for us, because this is where we spent time on our first date. And I had a proposal and a ring in my pocket, and I was trying to say the things that I'd written down. It wasn't coming out quite as beautifully as I'd planned, but I used the paper, and we had a really good conversation. I told Robin just how amazing I thought she was, that she had this passionate faith, that she was a real joyful person, that she makes everybody laugh, and that she's just very, very, very kind. She's got a gentle side to her, but she's also got a real strength and perseverance, and just basically wanted to spend the rest of my life with her, and to have a family together, and to do ministry together. And so I got down on one knee, and I didn't know it at the time, but there were lots of cyclists and walkers and stuff kind of queuing up, because I'd taken up the middle of this walkway here. And I got the ring out and put it, got on one knee, put it on Robin's finger, and thankfully she said yes, and so we embraced. And all of the cyclists and walkers and stuff were clapping and cheering, which was a nice moment. And so that's when we got engaged, and then we spent then the lockdown really kicked in, and it was a terrible time in one way, but it was actually really good for us because we managed to spend a lot of time eating together. We were able to live together during that period. We had lots of meals, and we did like marriage preparation courses, and we spent a lot of time just doing the things that we love and getting to know different characteristics about each other, some of the difficult stuff, some of the habits and stuff like that. But good, we've managed to work our way through those things already, which is good preparation. And and then we did one of the craziest things we'll probably ever do, which is try to plan a wedding during this lockdown period. And just so many fluctuations and changes along the way. And we're really sorry that you all can't be here to join us, but we're thankful in one sense, because for a while it looked like there'd be no weddings at all. We just want to recognize and celebrate all the people who've helped us along this journey, who've supported us, who've helped us to grow up, who've shown us love and kindness and generosity over the years. So we just wanted to say thank you for just being there for me and Robyn, and we'll celebrate our love together with you further down the line. And that just thank you very much. We just want to we hope this service will be a blessing for you as much as it is for us, and we look forward to catching up with all of you soon. Thank you for all of your gifts, and we love you. Take care and God bless.
What a guy. Now here's some more of you lot.
Well, hello. Croeso, although actually we're not welcoming you to our house, but you are welcoming us to your wedding virtually. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Hope the ceremony is amazing and you've got all the people there that can be there, and that you've got much merriment and mirth making to look forward to shortly. Congratulations from Gethin and Claire. We have been married, of course, as you know, for well over 3,000 years, and we haven't aged or had a crossword in millennia. So have a great, not a great day, but a great relationship, great marriage, a marriage of minds and a marriage of hearts, and remain friends. That's the big thing. Remain friends, good friends, best friends throughout your married life. God bless you all. Poor Bendith. Bye-bye. Here's Claire.
Oh, I'd just like to say loads and loads of love and congratulations to you both, and just pray that this day is going to be absolutely full of joy and peace and happiness and fun, and it's going to be a wonderful memory for you as you step out into this new adventure of marriage, and may you be totally blessed. And we love you. Look forward to seeing you both again and getting to know you more, Robyn, and just really excited for your future. Loads of love. Bye bye.
Bye bye. Bye bye.
Bonsoir, mon frère. Le pain pour toi.
Ah, merci, hein.
À quelle heure shall I start the preparation for dinner?
Dinner? Are you crazy? We have a video to make.
Pourquoi?
For the marriage of David and Robyn.
When?
I'm pretty sure it's right now.
Oh là là, tout à l'heure.
We need to go vite. Allez.
Hi guys, just want to wish you both a massive congratulations on this special day. Really gutted we can't be there celebrating with you, but really look forward to the massive party when we can. Hope it's full of love, sending you all of mine.
Hey guys, wishing you the best for the day. I hope you're enjoying it with your close family and loved ones. Also wishing you guys a lifetime of health, love, truth and good spirit. Congratulations. Love to you all.
Take 7.
Hey, congratulations, Dafydd and Robyn.
Have a great day.
Many blessings for the future.
And see you soon.
Bye.
Hey, Robyn and David.
just wanted to wish you a very, very happy wedding on the 29th of August. I really, really hope that you have a lovely day, and I hope the sun is shining for you, and I hope that God will bless you and your marriage, and yeah, really, really have an excellent, amazing time, and hopefully see you in the future at some point, maybe Cardiff or Cambridge, wherever God places you, yeah? Speak to you soon. Have a really wonderful day, and much love to you. Sorry, I can't be there in person, but yeah, have a splendid time. Love ya. Bye.
Hi, Dav and Robyn. Bob and Ross here. Have a wonderful wedding day. Really looking forward to meeting you, Robyn, and you look really lovely. And we're on Barrafundle, South Beach and Pembrokeshire. Just scan around a little bit. And it's quite nice here. I hope you come and see us one day.
And God bless you both in your marriage together.
Bye.
Bye.
Hello, Dafydd and Robyn. It's good to be able to greet you on your wedding day, and it would be lovely to be there. But however, I've just been reminded lately of when I first started teaching many moons ago in a Church of England school in Wolverhampton. Every day we had assembly, and every day the children sang this prayer, which appears in Godspell, but was influenced by Richard, Bishop of Chichester, back in the 13th century. And the prayer is this: day by day, three things I pray: to see you more clearly, to love you more dearly, to follow you more nearly, day by day. And that's my prayer for you as you start your married life. Have a lovely day. Bye.
Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No! It's Philly! How you doing, Robyn and Dafydd? Wow! Congratulations on getting married. That is great! Look, may God bless you guys, and may you have a super marriage, you know. And hey, listen, don't forget to do the floss, eh? Way! Go Feely, go Feely, go Feely, go Feely. Anyway, stay tuned as well, Little Disciples, St. Mary's Hornsey Rise YouTube. I'll see you there. Love you guys.
Congratulations, Dafydd and Robyn, for your wedding and your marriage. A marriage is a celebration of fun and love and loyalty. And I hope that you share many years of that happiness together. Sorry you couldn't be there because of this current pandemic, but I'm just happy that both of you are sharing that matrimony together. Thank you.
Hey guys!
Hey!
We are so excited about today! I'm so, so happy for you guys. This is just, I'm just so excited. Yeah, yeah. This is a huge step in you guys' lives. I mean, everything's about to change for sure now in ways that you can't even imagine. So we just really want to pray for you guys before you take part of this journey. And we just want you to know that we are with you here in prayer, even though we can't be with you in person. And we just want to pray for a blessing of the Lord to watch over you guys as you start your new lives together. Yes. All right.
Yeah, Father, I just want to thank you so much for these guys. I thank you so much, Lord God, for their union together. Father, I thank you that this is just a beautiful couple, that just their togetherness is just ordained by you, Lord, and their lives and their future together is created in heaven, and it's given to them here on earth, Lord. Father, I thank you for just their joy. I thank you for just the beautiful, beautiful couple that they are, Lord. And Lord, we just pray blessing over them. We just pray protection over them, Lord. Father, I just ask that just in the small ways that only you know, Father, that you would just supply their every need, Lord. I just pray for peace over today. I just pray for incredible heavenly joy, Lord. And Father, we just thank you. There's an absolute party in heaven, even though we can't have a huge party here on earth, Lord. Father, I thank you for their individual selves. I thank you, Lord, for the fact that they need each other's characteristics, that they need each other's personalities and gifts and weaknesses and strengths, Lord. And I thank you, Father, that in coming together, they are going to just sharpen each other and just bring your kingdom here, Lord. So bless them today. We are so flipping excited for them, and we just can't wait for them to be Mr. and Mrs. Lord. Just bless them today and just fill their hearts with so much joy and so much gladness, Lord. In your name, Father, amen.
Amen.
Love God bless you. You guys.
Love
Have
you.
Have a great day. Woo!
Hello. Congratulations on your wedding, on your marriage, this sacred union in covenant with the Lord. And I pray blessings for your marriage, that you will walk in the ways of the Lord, you will love each other and understand each other and forgive each other and draw near to our Lord in joyful times and in hard times, that you will always have His peace. And I pray all these things in Jesus' name and for His glory. Amen.
Hi, Dafydd and Robyn. I would like to bless you both. And who am I to bless you? Peter Mary, your brother. And I'd like to wish you here peace, joy, and love. May God bless you always. And I love you very much, both.
Yes, Doves. Yes, Robin. I wish you the best. Congratulations. And Doves, give her everything she wants. Robin, give him everything he wants. Just a little bit more as well, you get me.
Congratulations, guys. Wishing you a really amazing day. Hope it's amazing and blessed and on all you hoped. We pray that God will bless you both. God will bless your marriage, and that it will be fulfilling and long and happy. We just pray a blessing over your day today.
Amen. Very nice to meet you guys. Have a beautiful day, Dafydd and Robyn.
Amen.
Amen. See ya.
This is my prayer for you, Robyn and Dafydd. And it comes from Philippians 1:9-11. This is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in knowledge and depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless until the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes from Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God. Amen. Congratulations.
When you and Dafydd came down to stay with us in Oxford. What a wonderful lady you are. And we're so thrilled that Dafydd is marrying you.
Yay! 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 Dafydd, I'll never forget those super competitive games of baseball in Richard Gardens. Dav, it's been amazing to know you as you've grown up from a wee lad to the man you are today. Nice one. Cheers. Dav, if I remember, you running rings around me despite me being 15 and you being 5 on the football pitch. You were amazing.
Yay! I remember all those nights at pool in the garage and all those snacks and drinks we stole. Yay! And all the awesome big New Year's parties as well. Yay! And do you remember that family holiday to Spain? Hello! And where do I begin? It's been awesome. From endless Monday nights tag playing brutal uni hock to Bishopalander, amazing nights out and house parties, then weekends away in Felderbrennan and university with you. It was so nice to be there with you. I loved it. So we're so thrilled to celebrate with you this way. today, but we cannot wait to meet you, Robyn, and to celebrate with you in person very soon.
To Robyn and David, just want to say a big, massive, huge congratulations on your big day. I'm just so grateful and so happy that God has just brought this day where you guys can just come together and be joined in union and, you know, have a lovely day. I just pray that God just blesses this new journey for the both of you, that he guides you through it, and that it will just last forever and ever and ever. And yeah, I love you guys so much. You guys make a beautiful and amazing couple, and yeah, wishing you all the best, wishing you all the love, wishing you all the happiness for this new journey that you're about to venture on.
Hello David, it's Alf here, mate, aka El Capitan, aka the instigator, although that's Tom, your cousin, he's the real instigator. I hope you and Robyn have a great day. I hope it's like wonderful with all your family, and yeah, I can't wait to see you. We have to come down to Cambridge soon, and yeah, have a wicked day, see you soon.
Hey Robyn and David, best wishes on this wonderful journey as you build your new lives together. May the years ahead be filled with everlasting joy and happiness. I wish you the very best for the day, and God bless both of you.
Hi Robyn, hi David. I'm so glad that you guys are finally getting married despite the situation with COVID-19. We thank God for this opportunity of marriage, we thank God for your union, and hopefully see you soon. Greetings, bye.
Hi everyone, my name is Diane, and I met David and Robyn on the Stepney Area Intern Scheme. Robyn and Daf, congratulations on your special day. I really hope that you both have such an amazing time today, and that it's filled with lots of memories that you'll both be able to hold on to. Pray that you have a marriage that's so blessed with love, with laughter, and lots of fun. Congratulations, and hope you have an amazing day. Bye.
This is to Robyn, Anne and Dafydd from Brigitte and Alan Forsyth in Scotland. We're sending you our very best wishes and greetings for a long happy life together. While we're here, we're having a celebration to celebrate your wedding, although it's still 2 weeks ahead. I'm your granddad's younger brother. And we were married in Gothenburg in 1962. So in a couple of years' time we'll be celebrating our 60th wedding anniversary. And we'll be thinking of all the happy weddings that we've attended. And we're very sorry not to be attending your wedding in London. So, have a very happy day and enjoy all the company that you have.
We'll both be thinking of you on that day particularly.
In the Scottish sayings, we say, lang may your lum reek. Or another one is, may the wee moose ne'er leave your larder with a tear in his ee. In other words, Elspeth will translate it for you. Goodbye and good luck.
Hi guys, I just wanted to wish you the biggest of congratulations on your marriage. Robyn, I cannot believe I'm saying these words. It seems like yesterday that we met at uni. All of our songs that we have and all the times that we met up and danced in the street to Easy Street. You are an absolutely amazing friend to me, and I think that really hit me. I've always known it, of course, but I think I realised how important you were to me when you told me about becoming a priest, because I knew how much that meant to you. And it filled me with so much joy. I was so proud to hear you speak so happily, and I'm going to well up. I am so proud of you, and I am so, so happy that you've met Dafydd. And you two are an amazing couple. I've seen you blossom from the right from the beginning. I wish you both so much happiness and the biggest of congratulations. I love you both so much. Have a wonderful day.
Hi, Dafydd and Robyn, and congratulations on your wedding day.
It's unfortunate that we can't be there in person to celebrate with you, but we'll have a drink from afar in a room with a view. Dafydd, at this point, you'll just be waiting for your bride to show. Feeling a bit nervous and anxious, I'm sure. Don't worry though, she'll probably appear. Anyway, have a cracking day, and we'll hopefully be able to catch up with you soon for a proper celebration.
Cheers!
Cheers!
Congratulations to one of the newest and deeply in love couples in town, Robyn Nan and Dafydd. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Barbara, and also known as Mamia, and I'm one of Robyn Ann's mum's first cousins. Indeed, God makes everything so beautiful in his time. It's such a great honour to see you both getting married today. I pray that the Almighty God, who started a good work in you, will continue to guide and direct your path in everything that you do. Proverbs 18:22 says, "He who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favour from the Lord." Dafydd, you have found a wife, you have found Robyn Ann, and indeed you have found a good thing, and you have indeed obtained favour from the Almighty God. I pray that the Lord's favour will continue to be upon you both as you embark on this journey of marriage and you start a new chapter in your life. I've been married for 22 years and I can say it's sweet, and you have many, 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 many more happy years to come and blessings that come with it as well. Our dinner invitation with myself, Terry, Uncle Terry, and the rest of the family, the kids, is waiting after lockdown, and we cannot wait to see you both in our house to have a time of fellowship and entertainment. God bless you and have a fantastic day.
Dafydd and Robyn, wishing you just the best day. Really sad I can't be there, but I know that everyone around you is just loving you so much, and seeing how happy you guys are is just great. So I know it's gonna be a great day. I hope it's a great day, and I hope you have a drink, and I hope everyone is raising a glass to you everywhere, and I'll be tuning in. And yeah, just love you both. And Robyn, you're making him very happy. And Dav, we love you lots, mate.
Hi, Robyn and Dafydd. Hope you're having an absolutely wonderful day. Sorry we aren't with you physically, but it's been great. It will be great to watch on the Zoom on the service and later. Wish you the very, very best for today and for a long life together.
Yes, hello, Robyn and Dafydd. Hope everything goes brilliantly. I'm really thinking of you both starting your new and exciting ventures together. And I'm sure you're going to give each other lots of loving support, which you will also receive from up above. Bye for now.
Hi, Robyn and Dafydd!
I'm Afua.
Nana.
I'm Beba.
And we just want to say a massive congratulations. Robyn, you've been such a blessing to us, and we just hope that this journey is just full of blessings upon blessings upon blessings.
Robyn and Dafydd, have a good one. We just had so many memories together at Soul Survivor, you know, teaching us Sunday school, and we just hope that you just have fun in your new journey with Dafydd and together with God.
We pray for lots of babies and family house, and we just hope the best for you in the future.
Yeah, we just want to say a massive congratulations!
Bye-bye.
Hello there, Dafydd and Robyn. If you're watching this, I'll have to presume that you are in fact about to get married, actually. So I won't keep you long. You have got better things to be doing, haven't you? Yeah, can't be happier for you guys. Huge congratulations. Enjoy your day. I'm sure there'll be lots of smiling, dancing, singing, and all the rest. I will be watching on with a glass in my hand, or a pot of jam on this occasion, but has no relevance at all. Don't know why I did that. Love is the winner. Yes, indeed, love is the winner. Keep that fire burning, feel the rhythm, because you both got it, see? I don't know what it is, but you've both got it. Yeah, and when you've got two people that have got it, two good people, you put them together, you make the world a better place, don't you? Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Okay, well, we've sussed it then, haven't we? Lovely. All right, well, have a lovely day, guys. Enjoy every single moment. Really looking forward to seeing the pair of you soon. Congratulations again, and cheerio. Have a good one. Bye.
Hello, one and all. I'm Lucy, Robin Ann's aunt, and this is
Auntie Gina,
Grandma Gina, Robin Ann's grandma.
Yes.
And we are here to wish you both, Dafydd and Robyn, a wonderful, wonderful marriage. We are so excited. I am so looking forward to being part of your special day, even though we'll be online. I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be an exciting day. Make sure you enjoy and savour the moment. We will be in the background supporting you. I'm so excited for you that God has brought you together. And I'm sure that every blessing that comes with marriage will be your portion. In the name of Jesus, we thank the Lord for his favour. So, Grandma, is there anything you want to say?
Yes. May the Lord bless you abundantly, and may his favor follow you wherever you go, and may he lead you on this long journey to his destination. Whatever we do with the blessing and the hands of God in it, it goes well. So we are committing this wedding, this marriage, into his hand. May he take control. May he direct your footpath. May he lead you and bind you together. May his love never fade in you. We thank God for your life. And God bless you. We wish you all the best. God bless you. God bless you both.
Wonderful.
Have a wonderful day.
Enjoy your day, Dafydd and Robyn. Yes. And we look forward to meeting up with you when COVID is over.
Yes.
And when the lockdown is over.
Yes.
And everything is back to normal as much as possible. We will arrange a meet up. Enjoy your day. God bless you. We love you.
God bless you.
God bless you.
I mean, how lovely was all of that? So much love in all of those videos. And I know a lot of you guys can't be here, but that will mean the absolute world to Robyn and Dafydd. So, without further ado, it is time.
The marriage of Dafydd and Robyn. I'm pretty sure it's right now. I'm pretty sure it's right now. I'm pretty sure it's right now.
Oh la la, tout à l'heure.
I need to go vite.
Masks on, everybody, I think, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, because the video's going to, the live video's going to start now, so masks on.
Yeah, cool, thank you.
You're all good, aren't
you? Yeah, and you have a doctor if it affects your health, and don't wear any gloves. So absolutely. Yes, they have. I'm just going to grab.
On silent as well. Thank you.
our bride is here, which is lovely. And we're going to come and gather at the front and welcome them all in a moment. But please do stand for the arrival of the bridal party.
Thank you.
Sir Mary Hornsey rise and the wedding of Dafydd and Robyn. After maybe Dafydd manages to get his breath back. My name is Reverend Tamsin Manchins. I'm Vicar of St Mary's, and it really is my pleasure to take this service and ceremony today. Welcome to every one of you who has logged in online and watching here. And welcome to all of you who, I think everyone who's present in the building isn't just here for the service, but you've been here over the last few days getting the church ready and putting in so much work. It's lovely, actually, that this has been able to take place over the last few months. We've been watching and waiting with the news, and so it is a joy that we can take this service. And it's a sadness that only a few can be gathered in person. It'd be lovely if those of you who are here in person allow the service to go and don't take photographs, do enjoy the service. There's so many different people taking pictures, recording this service, and so enjoy. Pop them onto silent. If you're watching online, do feel free though to comment, to post, to... You can be as noisy as you like, because we're not going to hear you. And here in the building, we'll only be listening to the songs. We've got two lovely hymns. For those of you at home, please do sing for us. We are sad that we cannot sing. And there's a service sheet for everyone in the building, and there's been a service sheet sent to you online, so please do use that. We're trying to keep all the technology as simple as possible, and so there are no words on the screen. And do pray that all of the technology works today, that you can continue to join with us online while we gather together for this special day. So the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you, and also with you. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. So let us pray together. And this is one that if you're online, the words in bold, please do join in with those. So we pray together. God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts, and serve you always with willing minds, through Christ our Lord. Amen. To stay standing or sit if you prefer, as we listen and you sing online to this wonderful hymn, Come to a Wedding, which is sung by Miranda and Leslie. Celebrate love. come now to just our little introduction to marriage, and then Robyn and Dafydd are going to make their declaration. So do be seated. In the presence of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Dafydd and Robyn, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of God in creation, through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with one another in heart, body, and mind, as Christ is united with his bride, the Church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children are born and nurtured, and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship, and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honour. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Dafydd and Robyn are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. We pray with them here and at home that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly lives together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Robyn and Dafydd, the vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judgeable and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it. Dafydd Joshua Russell Jones, will you take Robyn Ann Acosia? Apologies for the technical delay for those of you at home. So we've had the reading, so if you want to read them later, do look them up. You can use a Bible app or you can go to Bible Gateway. But needless to say, our weddings were about love. Not surprising. So good afternoon, everyone, and welcome again to those of you joining us, hopefully still from home, on your laptops, phone and tablets. As I said, do pray for this technology, and welcome to everyone in here. I think it's been amazing to notice the transformation that's come in the church, but also actually what's been really lovely is to watch the relationship between Robyn and Dafydd unfold over this past year. And can I just say, for making a fabulous decision to marry each other. Now, it seems to be increasingly difficult today to sense when we should get married.
So, as usual, it's good to go to the experts. So here are some thoughts from some children about what is the proper age to get married. Carolyn, aged 8, said 84. Because at that age, you don't have to go to work anymore and you can spend all your time loving each other in your bedroom. Well, Bert, age 5, thought this: once I'm done with kindergarten, I'm going to find me a wife. Dafydd and Robyn met less than 1 year ago, and the decision to be married has come in this time. Well done, you. And so they've been working towards not just being married, not just to today, but moving to Cambridge, finding somewhere to live, preparing for a first year of married life, along with a first year of ordination training and teacher training. What a journey you're going to have. But that's what you've been preparing for. This lovely service, this day, this meal after, but a life shared together. Our two readings today help us in this task. The first one from the book of Ecclesiastes, in chapter 4, and the other one from the first letter of John. They're about love. They come at that question in different ways. They present us a very different picture of love, and they show us something of what love is meant to be. From that, I picked out three aspects that give us a picture of marriage and what Dafydd and Robyn have been working towards. The first is that love is about intimacy. It's shared in both the readings. The one in Ecclesiastes is lovely, isn't it? It speaks of the way that two are joined together, and then actually then the image of the rope of three strands not easily being separated, often used as an image of marriage and before God. But love, we see in John, is about being prepared to be open and honest, to be intimate about who you are. Intimacy in marriage is about sharing the most intimate aspects of who you are as people. Sharing your bodies in sex, sharing your minds, sharing your hearts and your souls. How are Dafydd and Robyn going to grow intimacy in their marriage? Well, apparently, if you want to be happy, healthy, successful and live longer, give your spouse a kiss before you go to work each day. That's the conclusion of a study conducted by a group of German physicians and psychologists in cooperation with insurance companies. According to Dr. Arthur Sasbrow, the study found that those who kissed their spouse each morning miss less work because of illness than those who do not. They also have fewer car accidents on the way to work. They earn 20 to 30% more monthly. And they live about 5 years more than those who don't even give each other a peck on the cheek. Now, I doubt in all honesty that this is simply because of a daily kiss. But I think that that daily kiss is an indicative kind of intimacy in the rest of the marriage. Because intimacy is something that requires a risk of rejection. If we want to share our lives with someone, then we need a secure place to do that. And today, Dafydd and Robyn have committed, will commit in front of us all to do that. They've made the first step to share their lives, to grow in intimacy. But is that enough? In John's letter, we see this picture of intimacy between God the Father and God the Son. We can love because God has not only shown us love, but loves us first. The writer is wanting to show us that it is out of love that we can love. And this works both ways. If you know the love of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, then you can love both God and others because He loved you first. And in that letter to John, you get this extraordinary sense of intimacy in that relationship, God, Father, and Son. And also this promise that if we love,
we respond to that love of God, that God comes and dwells within us. And that's the picture in Ecclesiastes of two who are joined with God. So he's saying this in John's letter: know first the love Christ has for you. And if you know that, you can love others. So, Robyn and Dafydd, know daily the love that God has for you. I know that that's been a bedrock of both your lives, but continue to make it so, so that from that love, you can love each other. It's a love that forgives. It's a love that always reaches out. If you know that love, then you will be able to do the same for each other. To grow in intimacy, we risk rejection because we offer ourselves. In the words of the writer Thomas A. Kempis, love flies, runs, and leaps for joy. It is free and unrestrained. Love knows no limits, but ardently transcends all bounds. Love feels no burden, takes no account of toil, attempts things beyond its strength. But love that is purely human so often fails, where love from God is constant. And so that's why the challenge to set your marriage on an intimacy that you know first from God and then to one another. The second aspect of the love in these readings is about love expressed in friendship. That was in Ecclesiastes. Two are better than one. On her golden wedding anniversary, Roderick MacFarlane's grandmother revealed the secret of her long and happy marriage. On my wedding day, I decided to choose 10 of my husband's faults, which for the sake of our marriage, I would overlook, she explained. A guest asked her to name some of the faults on her list. To tell the truth, she replied, I never did get around to listing them. But whenever my husband did something that made me hopping mad, I would say to myself, lucky for him, that's one of the 10. Friendship forgives faults in the other. Friendship is a commitment to share common interests and common passions with the other. Two of my friends got married, and one of them was an ardent Arsenal supporter, and the other wasn't really that bothered even in football. But they made a decision to choose to show interest, and they built until one is actually probably more passionate than the other in their support of that football team. And building friendship, growing in what you enjoy doing together as friends, will build a marriage that keeps growing towards each other rather than away. And friendship is so essential for this. And I know that friendship has been key in the building of your, the beginnings of your relationship. So continue in that journey, being friends. Now, there's some lovely titles of the love ballads you can sing your to your beloved. I don't know if you've come across these. Arnold, who's 10, said his was, how do I love thee when you're always picking your nose? Larry, who's 8, said, you are my darling, even though you also know my sister. And Sharon, who's 9, said, honey, I got your curly hair and your Nintendo on my mind. Finally, love is about sacrifice. Now, we see that in the writer of John's letter, that Jesus is the supreme example of sacrifice. God, who gives up all of heaven to come as a man. Love expressed through sacrifice. And then that man, Jesus, gives his life that we might have life. He puts his need for our relationship with God before his own life. That is sacrifice. And in our increasingly individualistic society, where we struggle and try and work out what it means to be human and intent on rights, actually, God shows us a really interesting way that though he had all things, he gave those up for us. And then, so one of the challenges in marriage will be for you to set out how to do that. Set out, and that's not becoming a doormat, being giving up things, being sacrificial, isn't the one or other of you just lay down before the other and say whatever you want. That is not sacrifice. I think sacrifice is seeing in this, that each of you, as you make your vows, choose to prefer the other in all things. And because you make a commitment at the beginning that each of you does that, you're each looking to the needs of the other. That you haven't got to grapple at times your own needs, because you know that Dafydd will do it for you and Robyn will be doing it for you. Now that's easier said than done, can I just say, because sacrifice is usually about giving up some pride. I'll need to be right, best or first. That's hard. But a daily challenge again, set not in our own gifts and not in our own strength to give that sacrifice, but in a reminder that Jesus sacrifices himself for us. So marriage. Make your marriage about intimacy. That's going to be vital. Kiss each other every day. Just maybe not all day, but maybe for the next few weeks. It's about friendship. Carry on and continue the good work of being friends. And then take time to know what the other wants. My hunch is that you're both going to be set on wanting the best for each other. And that's a good way to start.
Amen.
We are going to sing again. So online you have the words, we're going to, and at home we're going to, I'm confused now. Here in the church we are going to listen.
Yeah.
thank you. What a beautiful song, so beautifully sung. We're going to come now. So, Robyn and Dafydd, I now invite you to join hands and to make your vows in the presence of God and his people. I, Dafydd, Joshua Russell Jones.
I, Dafydd Joshua Russell Jones.
Take you, Robyn Ann Akosia Afria Forsyth.
Take you, Robyn Ann Akosia Afria Forsyth.
To be my wife.
Be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
This day forward.
For better, for worse.
Better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
Richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
To love and cherish and serve.
To love, cherish,
till death us do part.
Death to us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow. In the
presence of God, I make this vow.
I, Robyn Ann, Akosia Afria Forsyth.
I, Robyn Ann. Yeah,
take you, Dafydd Joshua Russell Jones.
Thank you, Joshua Russell Jones.
To be my husband.
Be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
Better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love, cherish and serve.
To love.
Till death us do part.
To death.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
Right, let's pray for the rings. We're going, Robyn and Dafydd are going to give and receive a ring. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Dafydd and Robyn, a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day. Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Robyn, I give you this ring.
Robyn, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
Sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
My body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
Body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give.
All that I am, I give.
And all that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
In the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy
Spirit. Father, Son, and
in the presence of God and before this congregation and those of you online, Dafydd and Robyn have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife.
Woo-hoo!
At least we know it makes you laugh. I'm going to wear a mask just for this little bit because I'm going to come and stand close and we're going to bind Robin and David's hands together with the mask on. Those whom God has joined together, let no one divide. I'm going to pray a blessing upon Robin and David. I'm going to register their marriage. A blessing. If you're at home, you may want to hold out a hand just to join with us here as we pray for God to bless this marriage. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon Dafydd and Robyn in their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, awake and asleep, in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessing of eternal life.
Amen.
We are now going to sign the registers, and during the registers, we've got a song that's being played by Leo. We can always
God, you're still at work.
We are just taking one or two photographs, which
so that once the registers have been signed, and thank you to Greg and Mark for that beautiful song. Very good sign of coming. And now we're going to have our prayers, and we've got prayers from Anne Forsyth in person, and then Gethin and Claire have recorded prayers, one in English and one in Welsh, that we're going to watch on a video. So let us join together in prayer.
Praise God! Praise God! Let's pray. Dear Father Jehovah God, we thank you for this beautiful day because you're a beautiful God. We thank you for all that you have done. It is because of you that is today is what it is. Because you are the greater I am, we bless your holy name for today. Father, we commit today into your holy hands. These two that has joined together, Father, let your anointing be upon them. Let your blessings be upon them. Father, bless them. Wherever they go, appoint divine helpers only to come to their help. Father, wherever their feet will touch, Father, your Holy Spirit will go there before they will touch it. Your presence will always go before them. Father, we know that you are the King of Zion. Father, we bless your holy name. Father, we thank you for today. And we ask in Jesus' mighty name that everyone that is here, Father, you provide us with every need, anything that within us that we're asking you for your mercy. Father, we ask in the mighty name of Jesus that you grant us so that today will be a big occasion that nobody else that has attended this service or is watching online will forget this special day. We love you, Jesus, but you loved us before us. We thank you because you are the greater that I am. You are Ancient of Days and no other power can compete with you. We thank you, Jesus. Father, grant them with many children in the mighty name of Jesus. Twins, triplets. Father, give them blessings, money, everything. Father, as well as making them hold you as their pillar in life. Father, I thank you today. Through your son Jesus' name, I have prayed. Amen.
Amen.
Together. Dear loving Heavenly Father, who knows our every breath and also created this amazing and beautiful world.
Dear loving Heavenly Father, who knows our every breath and also created this amazing and beautiful world, we thank you today for the marriage of Robyn and Dafydd. These two very unique people have found each other in a unique way, and it's a time of celebration and joy as a result. Father, do not let anything come between Robyn and Dafydd except more love for each other. May that love grow deep and secure and true as the years pass. I pray the blessings of Christ on each of them, that they may truly know their purpose in life is to be more like Christ, so this desire will be lived out in marriage. May there be honesty, respect, honouring, sensitivity, a quickness to forgive always, and an acceptance of each other's differences with a forbearance at all times. May love win the day, I pray. Nothing can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, and may this be so for Robyn and Dafydd as they grow together over the years in their marriage. I pray for all the blessings which heaven can give to be poured out upon them, and I ask all these things in the name of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Gadewch ni weddio yn gilydd. Let us pray. O ddiwain tad, trwy amserau a thymhorau, a thrwy'r blynyddoedd, trwy broffwydi a phatriarchiaid, a gwir a gwragedd diwiol, datgyddiais dy gynllun ar gyfer y byd. Yng Nghrist, gwneir dy gynllun yn glir. Gelwi ni i garu yn gilydd fel y caroddef ni. Wrth i ni ddathlu cariad Dafydd a Robyn at ei gilydd, ac ymlawenhau yn ei bywyd ynghyd, bydded i'w cariad ffynnu a blodeuo, ac i bywydau datguddio gwanwyn dy deyrnas, lle y gwneud popeth yn newydd a'i gwblhau. Gofynnwn hyn oll trwy Iesu Grist yn harglwydd. Amen. God our Father, through times, seasons, and over the years, through prophets and patriarchs, godly women and men, you revealed your plan for the world. In Christ, you made your plan clear. We are called to love each other as he loved us. As we celebrate Robyn and Dafydd's love for each other, rejoicing in their joined lives, may their love bud and blossom, so that their lives reveal the springtime of your kingdom, where everything is made new and completed in love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
So we're going to join together in the prayer that Jesus taught us, which is in your service sheets in English. So if you speak another language and you know the Lord's Prayer in that, then do say that in that language. Lovely to pray together. So as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. So we come now to our final blessing and dismissal. So actually, waiting for everything to be in place, the dress, the cameras, the microphone, the computers. But well done, Mr. and Mrs. Russell Jones. Walk out of the church, and I know you're going to have money to have photographs. A final blessing and dismissal, if you'd like to stand. And at home, do join and stand with us as we say a final blessing, and as the bridal party lead you, church. God, the Holy Spirit, make you strong in faith and love. Defend you on every side and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest upon you, Robyn, Dafydd, and all those who have come here and are watching at home, now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.